Welcome to our 11th episode on our journey through GitHub DevSecOps. In the past 10 videos, we've added a lot of security tests and security checks to find vulnerabilities in our code or in our dependencies. All these checks and tests were all executed against new code or new branch information. This is not good enough, Romano. I want to execute them also regularly for code that's already in production. How do we do that?
Good question. Let's have a look. This is also the topic of today's video, which is all about scheduled pipelines for production. So in our past 10 videos, we had a look at our DevSecOps pipeline, which we are building with GitHub. In there, as Padi already said it, we introduced quite a lot of security checks, which you can see all here. But all these security checks are only executed when we change code on any branch. But Padi, for me, that's completely good enough. Why should that not be good enough to execute these security tests when we change code? What else do we need?
Now imagine we have code that's deployed and running in production on a production system. It might be that it runs for quite a long time, say 2 months. In these 2 months, it might be that new security vulnerabilities were found in dependencies, so to say in code that we introduce or use in our own code, are found. This now means we also have a vulnerability within our application, and we want to know that so that we can manage that and make decision whether we want to keep on running or do a speed update or hotfix, for example. And this means I need to execute a bunch of these checks, especially the checks that are based on SCA, so software composition analysis, on a regularly basis on the code that's running in production.
Oh, okay, now I got it. So in production, our code could have vulnerabilities within some libraries, and we need that to check that on a regular basis. And having just our commits is just not good enough. So therefore, I would propose let's dive in into scheduled pipelines.
Exactly. That's what we want to do. Running the security tests regularly on the branch containing code in production.
For that, we can add a schedule to our GitHub action, which we will see in a minute. I would also propose that we create a new main pipeline file with this schedule in it, and we only contain the jobs which really need to be executed on a scheduled basis.
That sounds good. Let's do it only for SCA and container scanning then, so all the third-party dependencies.
So, as said, Padi, it is very easy to implement. You can see the code there. It's on schedule, and then we define the cron, which here is run every 6 minutes. The schedule will always run on the default branch and on the latest commit on the default branch in GitHub.
Wow, what a limitation. This actually means we need to make our production code the default branch. This has other implications too, such as, for example, GitHub proposes always the default branch for pull requests or merges, which makes it quite dangerous that somebody makes something wrong. Is there no better or other way than that?
Yeah, actually, there is another way where you can configure that over GitHub hooks and over references, but it's a lot of coding which you need to do, and I would propose to keep things simple. We will not do that in this video. So now we are back in our code. We head to our workflows and to our main pipeline YAML. We will go quickly into our web editor right now and close the files which we don't need. We quickly go in here. Here is our main pipeline YAML where we are going to execute all of our jobs. For our scheduled pipeline, I propose we do a copy of that file and paste that file again. We rename this file to schedule. We also call that schedule main CI pipeline. And then we are going to replace all of that with our schedule, where we say we want to execute this pipeline, in our case now every 6 minutes, but you will find a meaningful way. Perhaps you're going to execute that, for example, every day. Now, Padi, you said we should remove the parts which are not needed. I would say the build part is needed because SAST or the SCA needs this part here, so we keep that. But license compliance is something which we can replace. Then Docker and container image scan is something we keep. And Dust, as I think, is also something we can replace.
That's acceptable.
Good. With that, we have our scheduled pipeline. We are going to commit that. And push that. Let's head back to our source code repository and to actions. In here, we can see that this new pipeline, this new scheduled pipeline is running. This is our normal pipeline run, so this main CI CD pipeline run, which I'm going now to cancel. What we want to see in a few minutes is that a new scheduled pipeline run will be started with this scheduled main pipeline. So now what we can see is that the scheduled run has been executed. We can go in there, and as you can see, only these jobs which we have configured are now in here, and they will be executed now every 6 minutes. Just as a note, we configured every 6 minutes just for the demo, so that we can demo that to you. For you, it would be perhaps every day or every week.
Thank you, Romano.
You're welcome.
In this session, we learned how to use scheduled pipelines to make sure that our production code is regularly tested for new security vulnerabilities. We found that the current implementation of GitHub has some limitations regarding what branches you can use to do that. We also found that with a lot of additional work, it would be also possible to choose branches at your own needs. And this concludes this episode. In our next episode, we will give you our recommendations about using GitHub.